Lecture 2, Classical Genetics, Part 3. We will describe the equations, gene linkage, crossing over, and eukaryotic gene mapping. Chromosome theory of heredity. In 1902, Mendel's paper was read by Walter Sutton, who was a student at Columbia University in New York. Sutton was studying chromosomes in the cells of grasshoppers. Sutton and others were trying to learn more about how chromosomes behave when body cells reproduce during mitosis and when sex cells form during meiosis. Sutton noticed that the behavior of chromosomes during meiosis was similar to the behavior of the genes Mendel studied. The first, chromosomes as well as Mendel's genes occur in pairs. The second, paired chromosomes separate during meiosis. Each sex cell receives only one chromosome of the pair. Mendel's paired genes separate and each sex cell receives only one gene of the pair. The third, chromosome pairs separate independently of other chromosomes pairs during meiosis. Mendel's genes pairs separate independently of other gene pairs. The fourth, individual chromosomes return to their original paired numbers in the fertilized egg, and Mendel's individual genes become paired genes in the offspring. Putting all this information together, Sutton guessed that the genes Mendel studied were located on the chromosomes. During meiosis, the gene pairs segregate with the chromosomes, as shown in the diagrams. The genes are then passed on chromosomes to the offspring during fertilization. Sutton's observations formed the basis of the chromosome theory of heredity. When Mendel performed his experiments, he studied only 7 traits, but pea plants, like other organisms, have hundreds of traits. Since organisms have many more traits than they have chromosomes, Sutton concluded that many genes must be linked together on each chromosome. The idea that a string of genes is found on a single chromosome is known as gene linkage. The first diagram to the right shows that genes located on different chromosomes segregate independently. And we can find 4 types of gametes, with genes big A and big B, big A and small b, small a and big B, and small a and small b. 4 different combinations of genes. The second diagram shows that genes linked on the same chromosome cannot segregate independently during meiosis. And we can find only 2 types of gametes, dominant genes big A and big B together, and small a and small b, 2 recessive genes, on another chromosome. Question 2.6. Gene linkage. American geneticist Thomas Morgan performed studies of the fruit fly with his students, Bridges, Turtevant, and others, and found that linkage between genes may be broken due to exchange of segments of chromosomes, crossing over. Alfred Turtevant, Morgan's research student, created the first genetic map, included 5 genes on the X chromosome of Drosophila. He became a leading geneticist. Morgan chose to use fruit flies in his experiments. First, the fruit fly is easy to study because it has only 4 pairs of chromosomes, compared with garden pea plants that have 7 pairs of chromosomes. Second, fruit flies reproduce quickly. They complete a generation in 2 weeks. Therefore, researchers can raise many generations of flies in just a few months. Third, female and male fruit flies are easy to tell apart, so it is easy to remove females and keep them separate from the males. It enables researchers to select the parents and the traits to be studied. In the picture to the left, we can compare male and female organisms. Male is smaller and has white-black region on the tip of abdomen. Female is larger and has no such wide black band. Fourth, flies are small, about 2 mm in length, easily handled, easy to cultivate. Thousands of flies can be kept in bottles that take up very little space. The more flies the researchers observe, the more accurate their conclusions can be. Fifth, cells in the salivary glands of fruit flies have giant chromosomes, which have been useful in finding the locations of genes on the chromosomes. Morgan's experiments with linked genes. Morgan studied two different characters, body color and wing shape. Dominant gene, B+, determines wild-type gray body. Recessive allele, small b, determines black body. Dominant gene, VG+, determines normal wing. Recessive allele, VG, determines vestigial wing, greatly reduced in length. We can compare these two pairs of characters in the picture to the left. Morgan crossed homozygous flies having one mutation and obtained dihybrids B+, B, VG plus, VG, with gray body and wings of normal length. Then he mated those dihybrid flies with recessive homozygous flies, small b, small b, small vg, small vg. It is a test cross for the two gene pairs. Morgan expected to see four phenotypes in a ratio of 1 to 1 to 1 to 1, but that is not what he observed. The first cross. He used male organism from the F1 generation and crossed this male with recessive homozygous female. He received only two types of fruit flies. All flies resembled flies from the parental cross, so-called grandfather and grandmother, ratio 1 to 1. No flies with new combination of traits. Compare with the second cross. In the test cross of the female from the F1 generation and double recessive homozygous male with black body and vestigial wings, he received 83% of flies that resembled flies from the parental cross. Gray body vestigial wing, black body normal wing. And 17% of flies were black vestigial or gray with normal wings. They had new combination of traits. Morgan suggested that the genes for body color and wing length must be located on the same pair of homologous chromosomes. In the left test cross, linkage is absolute, that is, chromosomes always remain intact and unchanged, and genes are inherited together. Pay attention that crossing over occurs in males of fruit flies very rarely. Intact chromosomes of so-called grandfather and grandmother are inherited as whole chromosomes by these females. In the right test cross, genes at different loci on the same chromosome sometimes separate from one another when two homologous chromosomes physically exchange corresponding segments during prophase 1 of meiosis, that is, by crossing over. This crossing over in the picture leads to formation of new combinations of genes and traits. Complete linkage is linkage between genes that are located close together on the same chromosome, with no crossing over between them. Incomplete linkage is linkage between genes that exhibit some crossing over, intermediate in its effects between independent assortment and complete linkage. Linked genes in a dihybrid may be present in one of two basic conformations. In one, the two dominant alleles are present on the same homolog. This arrangement is called a cis configuration or coupling. In the picture to the right, we can find dominant gene big A and big B on the first chromosome and recessive alleles small a, small b on the second chromosome. Another arrangement in which each chromosome contains one dominant and one recessive allele is called a transconfiguration or repulsing. The two conformations are written as follows. Big A, big B slash small a, small b, cis configuration. And big A, small b slash small a, big b, transconfiguration, where a slash symbolically separates the two homologs. In the picture to the right, we can compare two possible dihybrids. For example, we have determined that distance between genes A and B equals 1.2%. Distance between genes A and C equals 3.5%. Distance between genes B and C equals 4.7%. Hence, the order of genes is as follows: B, A, C. Linear order of genes. Morgan's law. Genes are located in chromosomes linearly, in certain loci and move from one homologous chromosome to another chromosome with a frequency that is directly proportional to the distance between genes. Recombinant frequencies will be greater for loci that are farther apart on the chromosome than for loci that are closer together, because an exchange event is more likely to occur between genes that are far apart than between genes that are close together. Morgan unit is a unit for expressing the relative distance between genes on a chromosome. One Morgan equals a crossover value of 100%. A crossover value of 1% is a centimorgan. Genes located together on the same chromosome belong to the same linkage group. The number of linkage groups is equal to haploid number of chromosomes, n, and in organisms with sex chromosomes equals n plus 1. There are 24 linkage groups in humans, 22 autosomes plus X chromosome and Y chromosome. Question 2.7. Crossing over. Morgan's studies have shown that genes linked on the same chromosome are sometimes separated. Sometimes during meiosis, the homologous chromosomes twist around each other. Part of each chromosome may break off and become attached to the other chromosome of the pair. This process is called crossing over. Stages of crossing over. The first, homologous chromosomes pair. Each chromosome has doubled, but the doubleness is not yet visible at this stage. The second, chromosomes wind around each other. The third, doubleness of each chromosome is not visible. Chromosomes break and exchange equal amounts of chromosome material. The fourth, chromosomes move partly away from each other so that the exchanges are visible. Such point is called chiasma. The fifth, chromosomes separate, each with new genetic information. The effect of crossing over is that it can provide new combinations of alleles in the sex cells. For example, suppose that the genes for eye color and hair color are linked on the same chromosome, as shown below. Dominant gene big B is an allele for brown eyes. Recessive allele small b is an allele for blue eyes. Big H allele for brown hair, small h allele for blonde hair. The alleles for brown eyes and brown hair are found on one chromosome. The alleles for blue eyes and blonde hair are found on the homologous chromosome. The first picture in the bottom to the left. When sex cells form, they will either carry alleles for brown eyes and brown hair or for blue eyes and blonde hair. However, if crossing over occurs, new combinations are possible. Some sex cells might receive a chromosome that carries the alleles for brown eyes and blonde hair, big B and small h. Others might receive a chromosome with alleles for blue eyes and brown hair, small b and big h. Cytological evidence for crossing over. Creighton and McClintock obtained evidence that intrachromosomal recombination was the result of physical exchange between chromosomes. They studied the inheritance of two traits in corn. Also, the chromosome in one plant carried a knob at one end and a small additional fragment at the other end. This aberrant chromosome allowed them to visually distinguish the two members of a homologous pair. Then they obtained a dihybrid. In the progeny of a test cross of this plant, they compared the chromosomes carrying new allele combinations with those carrying parental alleles. They found that all the recombinants inherited either a knob or an extra piece. We can find in the picture new recombinant chromosome with two dominant genes, big A and big B, with a knob, and another recombinant chromosome with two recessive genes, small a and small b, with extra piece of a chromosome. Thus, there was a precise correlation between the genetic event of the appearance of new allele combinations and the chromosomal event of crossing over. Factors influence crossing over. The first, sex. Crossing over occurs in males of fruit flies very rarely, but sex does not affect crossing over in humans. The second, chromosome structure. Centromere, deletion, and inversion prevents crossing over. The third, crossing over inhibits additional crossing overs in the same region of the chromosome. Such phenomenon is called interference. The fourth factor, age. Frequency of crossing over is higher in young and old females of fruit flies. The fifth, external factors. Radiation, high temperature, and some chemical substances, for example EDTA, increase frequency of crossing over. Question 2.8. Eukaryotic gene mapping. Chromosome map is a scheme showing the locations of genes or other markers, for example restriction sites, on a chromosome, their order and distance between them. There are two types of maps of eukaryotic chromosome. The first, genetic map. Also, it is called a linkage map. Linkage map is deduced from genetic recombination experiments. Map unit is 1 centimorgan or 1% of crossovers. How to construct linkage map? To receive mutations, to receive diheterozygote or dihybrid, to perform test cross, to calculate descendants, percentage of all crossovers equals distance between genes. But one limitation exists. A double crossing over produces non-recombinant gametes, hence the recombination frequency between two genes cannot exceed 50%. Therefore, genetic maps based on short distance are always more accurate than those based on longer distance. In the picture to the left, we can find that double crossing over occurs, but no new combinations of genes can be found in gametes. The second type of maps of eukaryotic chromosome is physical maps. The first, cytogenetic map. The second, nucleotide map. Gene size and distance between genes is represented in base pairs, BP, or thousands of base pairs, KBP. The third variant, restriction map. A diagram portraying a linear array of sites on a DNA segment at which one or more restriction endonucleases cleave the molecule. In this picture, we can compare physical or cytogenetic map and genetic map. Physical genetic maps differ in relative distances. In the first picture, genes A, B, C, D, we can find identical distance between genes, approximately 33%. The second map is genetic map, and we can find that between the first and the second gene, distance is very large, 54.5%. Between the second and the third gene, this distance is very small, approximately 3%, 3 centimorgan. Distance between the third and the fourth gene is very large, approximately 49.5%. Compare with distance on physical map, approximately equal distance, 33%. Conclusion. Centromere reduces recombination frequency. Frequency of recombination must be approximately 33%, but in experiments we can find only 3%. Methods of construction of cytogenetic map. The first is deletion mapping, overlapping deletions in polyteen chromosomes. Small part of a chromosome can be deleted, enzyme will disappear in a cell. The gene for this enzyme is located on the deleted segment of polyteen chromosome. The second method, somatic cell hybridization. Human and rodent cells are fused. The hybrid cells lose human chromosomes during division. It allows to assign the gene to the correct chromosome. The third, in situ hybridization. Fluorescence label is added to a fragment of DNA that is complementary to a specific gene. This probe is then added to specially prepared chromosomes, where it binds with the gene of interest. The presence of the label on a particular chromosome under the fluorescent microscope reveals the physical location of the gene. Such method is called FISH, fluorescence in situ hybridization.